Just like your favorite cartoon shows in the 80s, you run downstairs to catch that latest episode on a Saturday morning. But in this case, you're going to catch the hottest selling cards in Magic. That's right, it is today's Hot Top 10. Here we go, we're back for the Hot Top 10. How's it going out there, YouTube? I hope you guys are having a great day. On this Saturday morning, it's pretty cold. Here in Toronto, it's pretty freezing, man. So on the hottest selling cards this week, I gotta be honest, there's some new entries, some new stuff moved up, but it's really fascinating to see how many of these cards like stick around. This time and time again, some of these cards seem to like stay on the hot top 10, like they don't wanna leave. They're like hanging on for dear life. Like, no, I don't wanna go! That's all they're doing. So let's go ahead, let's take a look at some amazing cards. It also kind of lets you know what decks people are building just by looking at the hottest selling cards, because you can see where people's parking their money, where people park the money and say, that's a good card, I like it, I'm gonna build a deck with this. You know, very interesting stuff. So let's get started, let's see what's going on. And this is MTG Moxman, because I forgot my own intro, and that's okay, because you guys probably know by now. All right guys, let's get this started. Coming in at number 10 this week, it is Dress Down from Modern Horizons 2. Not Dress Up, it's not Mr. Dress Up, we're talking Dress Down. We're going down low. Like the artwork, Dress Down here is one blue, one other, has flash, it's an enchantment. You can see here, when Dress Down comes into the battlefield, you get to draw a card. Creatures lose all abilities. That's an interesting thing. I mean, I can see why it has a lot of sales all of a sudden, you're like, oh. And then, you know, at the end of the turn, it's gone. The end of the end step, poof, it's gone. Now it's $2.93 US. The market has it at $2.68 US. A foil's gonna run ya. This is interesting. $10.77. Look at the disparity in prices. And when I looked this up and looked at some Canadian places, which by the way are around $5, I was very interested. Like this is a nice actual foil multiplier that has some differentiation. I like it. And then it's €2.24 to get to that card. It's having a bit of a bell curve there. You see how it's kind of going up because the sales are increasing. 276 sales is respectable. That's pretty high. I remember we couldn't even get that on the Hot Top 10 until I started finding more websites where I could get the data from. So cool stuff. Way to go. Dress down, not dress up. Let's go check out number 9 on the list today. Number 9 is still hanging in there. Refuses to die and wants us to consider it. Consider from Innistrad Midnight Hunt comes in at number 9, 287 sales, average price is $2, the market is 175, a foil is still 279, and it's €1 to get you that card. I can see why people still buy it. I was curious to see that it still made the list. I thought it would fall into like the 150 range. Nope, this card just doesn't want to go anywhere, and it's a very interesting card, right? People like the mechanic, and a lot of people are talking about the card, but it is a common. It's a common! Haven't you guys bought enough of this card already? Stop buying it. Let's buy something else. Let's get a new card in the top 10. No, I know. It's not going to change. Next week, Consider's probably going to be here, or people are going to surge now and buy it, and everything I said is wrong now. Yeah, we'll find out. All right, number 8 this week is Stormkiln Artist. Strixhaven, School of Mages. Way to go. A Strixhaven card made the list. Coming in at number 8. 291 sales January 15th to the 21st of 2022. Now look at that. Average price, $1.98 US. Markets, $1.94 US. A foil, I like this, there's a difference. $4.54 US. And of course, not even €1, just 64 cents to get you that card. An interesting card. I like the fact you get a whole bunch of pluses when you pump out artifacts. I'm not quite sure why this card is selling so much. I don't know it that well or what mechanics are going with this card, other than the fact it's obviously treasure tokens of some type being pumped out to make this guy insanely sick and he just swarms over somebody. I guess that's it. You guys can put that in the comment section and edumacate me. Let me know how things are going, because for sometimes in the future, in the past, I can't remember how to play this because I don't use this card in my arena deck. I just don't. Although I'm thinking about doing something now to see what happens with it. Coming in at number 7 is Dam from Modern Horizons 2. No, not a dam that holds back water, but obviously everyone just gets messed up. Because this card can destroy that single creature you want to get rid of, or you can overload it with some white mana and go boom to the whole world, good old Wrath of God style. I like this card. I already told you guys I enjoy it. I like the fact it kind of mixes some colors in there, little interesting effects. Way to go. Definitely is seeing some high sales with 305 sales from January 15th to 21st of 2022. Average price is $3.80 US. The market's $3.28 US. $5.10 for the foil US. I wish it was $6 just to kind of keep it always at the double, but I'm just happy to see some foil variation. You guys know how I feel. And $2.91 euro to get you that card into your house. Way to go. It started out, you know, fairly high and then crashed down to nothingness. So I expect this card to stay down here. Just sit, stay. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at number six. Number six this week is Nettlesist, Modern Horizons 2. I assume I pronounced that right. You guys will tell me. Now, 396 sales is a boatload of sales from January 15th to 21st of 2022, and I've never used this card. I'm sure I have a couple from all the Modern Horizons 2 I cracked here for the channel and the ones I opened personally. Living Weapon, Phyrexian Germ Token. I like where this is going. I used to have my Batter Skull deck. It was a lot of fun. So this guy obviously just kind of fits in there. So now I got to mess around. With that many sales, somebody's on to something. The card is just starting to uptick a bit. Average price is $176. The market has this card at $1.59. A foil is not quite there, but it's better than some. $2.57 and €1.01 to get you that card. Look at that spike it started out with and then crashed down. But cards like this generally don't stay down. It's like a form of Living Weapon that you could adjust and build a deck around, add some Batter Skulls in there and just say, hi, I'm your friend, and I'm a big scary Hydra looking thing that's just gonna come out and get you. I like that. I like the idea of it. I like the art. I don't know why I never recognized this card before. Sometimes I get surprised. I like that. All right, number five this week is gonna be Deadly Dispute. Adventures in Forgotten Realms. That's right. This card's coming in at number five. It's a common. One black, one other. As an additional cost, you know, you got to sacrifice a creature, but hey, you get to draw cards and you get a treasure token. I've seen other treasure token guys. We got that Kiln guy. Treasure tokens are going to be a thing. This is working to something big. It's going to be broken. I can smell the fire. I can smell it. I don't know where it is yet, but I can smell the fire of all that treasure burning up to do bad things. That's what's going to happen. So Deadly Dispute. 403 sales January 15th to 21st of 2022. Now, as a Forgotten Realms card, yay, I'm glad a card made it on the list again. But let's see if it can stay here. Like old Gnawbone and those guys got the Red Dragon. They all got knocked off in a single week. So we have to see if these cards actually have some staying power. All right. Now, the average price is $2.75. The market is $2.68. In Canada, it's around $3 a card. And it's a common. Think about that. It's a common. I guess the price isn't that common. All right, and the foil is $4.51. Foil here is about $7, by the way. And then, of course, we got to end things off with €1.75 to grab you that card. And you can see it's kind of bell curved. It kind of went up and it's kind of drifting down now. But with sales like that, I don't think it'll drift down that far. And I'm kind of surprised to see the amount of sales it has. It's got to be a powerhouse card that people are really working with. So really keep an eye out. I think treasure tokens are really going to be a thing. Again, you guys can give me some info in the comment section. Let me know what's what. There are way smarter people on this channel than me. So let's see where this goes. Let's go ahead and take a look at number four. Number four this week is Yavimaya Cradle of Growth hanging in there. Modern Horizons 2, chilling. I'm going to sit down by that tree with my morning coffee. Going to kick back and just praise the fact that it makes all my lands a forest. In addition to other things. I like it. I like this card. And the price is way down. Which is what I like to do with cards like this. This card is going to start going up when Double, Triple, Quarter Masters comes out. That's what it's going to go up, right? As soon as I get my nachos and cheese, that's when the price is going to flip. So, 412 sales January 15th to the 21st of 2022. You can see this card's only coming around $12 US. Market's around $11.30 US. A foil's $15.13. That's too close for comfort. Wow. Cheap price. I go for the retro art foil ones that I like. They're just so pretty to me. I can't help myself. I've got four and I might go for six. I might get a couple more. And then €7.83 to get this card. If you want to wait for it, go ahead. I don't think it's going to drop much further. This isn't a financial channel, purely entertainment. Go get a financial advisor somewhere. But I think this card's going to stick in there for another couple months and then slowly start upticking as more sets come out and the money moves on. When money moves on to new sets, old stuff gets left behind until somebody needs it for a deck. And then the supply starts drying up. So keep an eye on it. Let's see what comes up there, okay? Now our next card today is going to be Counterspell. Just like last week, number three, Modern Horizons 2 is the particular copy people like. 463 sales, January 15th to 21st of 2022. It's amazing to think the Counterspell was in Alpha, Beta, Unlimited. It just keeps going. It is the go-to Counterspell. but they don't print it like standard sets anymore. When was the last time they printed in a standard set? It's always in these specialty like sets. They don't want you having that good of a counterspell anymore. They don't want you to have that. No, no, no. Now, the average price is $1.59. The market is $1.47. A foil is $1.90 US. And hey, it's not even 1 euro to get you that card. But 463 sales, that is a lot of sales to get us where we're going. You got to show respect. That's a lot. A lot of people decided to counter stuff this week. Now, number two, Esper Sentinel. We talked about him last week. And look at that, 503 sales. January 15th to 21st of 2022. Locally, somebody bought 30 copies all at once. 30 in one shot. That is a lot. And then you go online, you look at the sales figures across all the little sites I go to. Wow. This guy is racking up serious firepower, okay? And you can see the price is starting to uptick. So Esper Sentinel, Modern Horizons 2, 503 sales January 15th to the 21st of 2022. Not bad, right? For a week of sales? Wow. The average price is $23.92. The market is $21.40. A foil is going to run you $40.46. Whoa. And then €17.63 to get you that card. He's an amazing card. Don't get me wrong. But wow, that is a lot of sales. I'm impressed. The Sentinel is standing guard for all of us, and he's guarding somebody else's money. Because if we bought one, we gave somebody some money for that card. Or it might be he's guarding your money. Maybe you've got him, and you're just holding on to him. Hold the line, man. Got to guard. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the number one card this week. Can you guys guess? What do you think? I have you hanging on pins and needles yet? You're probably paying me at double speed right now. Some of you guys play this thing at double speed. You know that shows up so I know you're not watching the whole video? I know. Let's go check it out. Number one. And that is the Voidwalker again. 527 sales. Modern Horizons 2. 15th to the 21st. Guys, look at this guy. Average price is $10.20. The market is $9.90 US. A foil is $11. Way too close for comfort. Those cards are too close. And then €9.12 to get you that card. But you know, it's right at the end there. In the last 2 weeks, look at the uptick. Look at that last little block of time. And you can see the price has drifted up ever so slightly. Because with these sales figures and people buying four at a time, there's just not enough supply really without opening up new product. It's something people have to understand, the supply and demand feature. But as the money moves on, a lot less things of the older stuff get opened up. And if you have it, you're less likely to sell it because you're like, oh, I don't want to like lose this. And then if I need it later, exactly. So things can go wrong when you least expect it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the top 10 videos this week. Thanks a lot for chilling out with me, having your Saturday morning cartoon break with me. Well, you had some, I don't know, you had some Captain Crunch there, or you're like an older person having some high fiber stuff. I don't know. Whatever it is, I hope you enjoyed it and you had a good time. Me, I'm going to go now, have my bacon, kick back and have a good time, and go in the freezing cold and walk a dog. See you guys soon. Enjoy the rest of your Saturday. And of course, a big shout out for my Saturday, Sunday, every day of the week patrons. Thanks a lot to the amazing patrons on this channel. Without their support, we would not be where we are. Thank you so much, guys. Patrons make the world go round, and I just can't thank you guys enough. You're awesome. I still remember waking up on Saturday mornings, running downstairs and watching like everything from GoBots to Transformers, but also Dungeons and Dragons. Remember that? And of course, don't forget, Power Word Kill. I remember killing 9 hit dice. I remember the Ravenloft novel, Lord Soth, and he goes against a small red dragon that's attacking him, and he just says die, and the dragon just dies. It was so epic. So for that reason, Power Word Kill, man. Oh. That box is getting pretty full. So guys, ladies, gentlemen, everyone out there, I hope you're having an awesome day. Remember, shop smart, shop S-Mart. Have an awesome Saturday. It is cold. It's really cold. And I already walked the dog. I'm not going again.